The Family Feud. Introducing the Boutisse family, Gary, Karen, Ralph, Val, and Tom, ready for action. And the Parch family, Lotsa, Dick, Joanne, Stacy, and Lisa, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. And now, here's the star of the Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So, Johnny Gilbert here. I thought I was dying for about 3 seconds. A very nice welcome. Johnny Gilbert is standing in for our... First of all, will you help me thank Johnny for being here? Johnny, nice to have you here. Our good friend and announcer, Mr. Gene Wood, attacked himself with a chainsaw just a few days ago. Cut himself where? In the ankle?
Yeah.
Did he hit the tendon at all?
It was quite unpleasant.
I don't care how unpleasant it was. Did he hit the tendon?
Yeah.
Medically, I'd like to know. He had about 18 stitches in it, but we've spoken to him and he's fine. He will not, of course, be able to go discoing as he usually does. Roller skating's out for a while, but we love you, Gene. Come on back and see us. Tell him we love him, please.
Good taste, good taste.
Hey. How you doing?
Good, real good.
How much money you want, Gary?
$5,353.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Glad to meet my family, Richard. It's my lovely wife, Karen.
Hello, Karen.
Hello, Richard.
It's my cousin, Ralph.
Hello.
Hey, Richard.
Hello,
how are you?
Boy, this is his beautiful wife, Val.
Hi, Val.
And my oldest brother, Tom.
There's a nice family here to challenge you.
Parch family, make them feel at home. You're looking good here.
Thank you, Richard.
How do I say that?
Lotsa.
Lotsa? Is that a Dutch name?
It's German.
German?
Yes.
Lotsa.
Mm-hmm.
What does it mean? What would be the equivalent in English? Larry?
No, it's
Lenny?
A surname.
Oh, is
named
it?
Named after Hermann Rudolph Lotze.
Oh, yeah. I haven't heard
you
from
remember him.
We were talking about him the other day. He did Hogan's with us. Just a wonderful one. Can I meet all of your family,
I'd
please, Lotze?
I'd be happy to introduce them to you. This is my son, Dick.
Nice to have
Richard.
You here, Dick.
His wife, Joanne.
Joanne.
Their daughter, Stacy. And Lisa.
Now, that name is the name of a famous cartoonist that I adored.
Virgil.
Was in Virgil, Vip. V-I-P. Hmm? Famous cartoonist in New Yorker magazine. You related to?
Cousin.
Are you?
Yes.
Is he still around?
Very much so. He lives in Laguna.
Does he?
Yes.
Oh, he's a marvelous cartoonist. I should get a cartoon and bring one in. Cause
Big George.
Yeah, he's really good.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Tell him hi when you speak to him.
I'll do that.
Do you speak to him often?
No.
Well, it'll be good
he's,
reason
he's,
you could give him a
call.
He's
pretty hard to get to.
Oh, is he?
Yes.
Well, it's just...
He has one bar he hangs out at.
Well, call the bar.
Yes.
And say, Lotsa, the cousin is calling.
Yes.
And when you get to him, say, Richard says hi.
I'll do that.
Why do I feel the Virgil will never hear my... Excellent. What have we got here, Dick?
Well, this is for my father, too. Richard?
This is a Coulter pine cone from Idlewild. And it's a very small sample. They get about this much bigger around, about that much higher. But I thought you had a room so full of junk now that you couldn't use a bigger.
This is marvelous. Now, this is varnished, because they close up and open in the weather, but
that's
the varnish.
That's not varnished. It's merely put in the oven, and the natural sap melts down, and it looks like varnish.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Well, it's a shame Gene Wood's not here to hear the words
<Let's see that>.
Natural sap. Thank you, sir. I shall put it in my room.
You're welcome.
Let's play the Feud. Come on. Feel.
Yeah,
give
right
that a whack.
In, yeah.
It'll be alley-up time. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. You've got to try and get the most popular answer. Gentlemen, here's the question. Name one of the doubts a woman might have about her fiancé.
He's too old.
Ah. Age. Not there. Gary?
Is he true to her?
Okay. Is he true?
Yes, sir.
Number one answer. They're going to do. Play a pass.
You guys want to play?
Thanks.
We're going to play, Richard. We're going to play.
Did you ever have that doubt about him when...
Never.
When
never.
He was your fiancé?
Never.
You knew he wasn't, right? What are the doubts a woman might have about her fiancé?
Is he going to work hard?
Uh-huh.
Good job.
Is he a hard worker?
Good answer.
All right. Oh.
All right. Oh, wait, Richard.
What do you think? What do you think? What's one of the doubts a woman might have about her fiancé?
He's been married before.
Okay, that'd be a doubt?
Yeah.
Has he been married before?
Has he been married gotcha. Before?
Good answer.
Has he been married before?
I doubt it.
Hi.
Mwah. What do you think, my love?
I think I'd wonder if he'd want to have children.
That's a good answer.
Good answer, honey.
Good answer.
Good one.
Good answer.
And if he did, he'd be the first. Children? Help?
I think,
Say hello to me, friend.
Hello, Richard.
One of the doubts a woman might have about her fiancé.
If he drinks.
Good answer.
Because, you know, if he's got a funnel in his pocket, and a long straw, that would give you a reason to doubt. If he's there, okay. If not, third stripe. It's a good answer, Jim. Does he drink?
Not there.
$61 up here, Lutza, can be yours. If you get your merry men around you. Need an answer?
We'll go with companionship.
Right. Will he be a good companion?
Yes, sir.
All righty. If he's a good companion, Lutza, you get $61. If not, Gary and his family get it. A companion that's swell. Here we go. Just the opener. Will he love her? Four?
Trustworthy.
Boy, they're really demanding a lot now. Number five? Can he walk? Oh.
Right.
Is he right for her? No, but what the hell? You can be happy without being right. We'll be back right after this.
Let's play Concentration.
On TV for the first time in 25 years.
That's a match.
Classic Concentration with Alex Trebek. Today at 1, only on Buzzer.
61 there, nothing there. Dick, I need you. Gave him the show business handshake there, didn't you?
Yeah.
Put the wrong hand out. You didn't seem very sincere to me, Karen.
Glad to see you.
100 people surveyed, top 8 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a kind of place people sneak out of.
A bar.
A bar? Okay. 7 answers will beat it, Karen. Kind of place that people sneak out of.
A bad party or company's house?
Okay. Bad party. You got it. We're going to play a pass.
We're going to pass.
All right. Well, I get to meet Park family.
All right, let's go, Mom.
How are you doing? I want to say hello to you.
Thank you.
Nice to have you here.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Kind of place people sneak out of. I can't imagine you ever sneaking out of anywhere, but I want you to give me...
Maybe a doctor's office?
Okay.
All right.
Doctor? No? Well, I sneak out of mine. You look pretty. What do you think? What kind of place do people sneak out of?
School.
Okay. Any of our 100 people say school? Did you do that? Hello. What would you think?
Church.
Okay, let's go. Church. Now, what do you think, sir?
I'll have to say a body house.
A body house. What a delicate way to phrase it. Body house? No. Oh. That kind of place that people sneak out of.
Mm.
The house.
The house. Okay, people do that. If it's there, okay. If not, third strike. Out of the house. No. $48 up here, guys.
We got it.
We got it. Work, Gary.
Work, all right, Gary.
Work.
I'm going to have to say work.
Yes. Work?
Work.
Yes.
Yes.
Work is there, you get the money. If not, we give it to Lutz and his family. Work! Motel's got to be there.
Motel's got to be there.
Hasn't it?
It does.
Well, I always wore my fake mustache. Number two. Number five? Six? I don't think so.
Yeah.
I sneak in there. Come on now, don't let me down. What about a motel? You see, crime does pay. Look at that.
Here we go.
Lower than the jack, it's a deuce.
Oh, and then lower than the ace.
Bingo.
Card Sharks, today at 4:30. Brought to you by Consumer Cellular, where low rates and award-winning service are just the beginning. At this
ordering court, 61 there, 48 there, let's go. Good Lord alive. She was so sweet, I didn't say anything. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name a pet you might have several of at the same time.
Go ahead. Kittens.
Kittens. Very good. One answer to beat it.
Puppies.
Puppy. Okay, what are you going to do? Play a pass.
Give that to my wife.
Untouched by human hand. You have a gorilla in the kitchen.
Come on, Stace.
Pets you might have several of at the same time.
Chicks.
Okay.
Chicks. Yes. Yeah.
Chicks. See? I've got those piranha. They're doing so well. We've lost three maids, but the fish are... I don't know. Fish!
Puppies.
We have puppies.
Oh, excuse me.
They're called dogs.
Oh, they are?
Even though you are going to call Virgil, I have to give you 3 seconds.
Calves.
Calves. Calves. I've got four or five of them at home. Calves. Dick. You know I like him, but don't tell him that's a good one. You say to him, Dad, that's a silly answer.
My
okay,
dad.
Silly answer,
a pet you might have several of at the same time.
Come on, dude.
Rabbits.
Good. Bunnies. That's a good answer. 244 plays 61. Let's go. Come on. You go to school, Stacy?
Yeah, Wilson High School, Long Beach.
Yeah?
Uh-huh.
Got some nice teachers there?
Yeah.
Well, you better say yeah if you're still going, right?
I know.
Only later I can talk to you seriously. You don't go to school, do you?
No, I'm too old for that.
Don't get testy, I just asked you. It's hard to make conversation with someone you don't know very well.
I'm sorry, I know you well.
You still growing?
I hope not.
Well, I'll have to give up. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something some men do every time they pass a pretty girl.
Yeah. Whistle.
Whistle. One answer will beat that. What do you think that some men do every time they pass a pretty girl?
Stare at them.
Stare at them? Okay. I'm sorry.
Come on, Lise.
Something that some men do every time they pass a pretty girl.
Ask them their name.
Hey, what's your name? No, not that. But so what do you think the men do?
Wink. Wink.
Wink.
Both eyes.
They'll be gone by the time you... Oh, but I got you. Right. Wink. Three seconds.
Okay. Come on, Mom. Come on, Mom, let's go.
I don't know. This may be the same.
Well, you just tell me and I'll...
Say hi.
That would be the same as talking, I'm sure. Even say hello, I think.
Yeah. Say hello. Well, if it was in Italy, they might pinch you.
There you go. Okay, if it's there, my love, all right. You'll play for the big money. You'll be the champs. If not, third strike, you get a chance to steal. Do they pinch? Nope. Come on, Gary. You need this money to stay
right,
in
Gary,
the game.
Come on,
something
Gary.
Some men do every flirt. Time they pass flirt. A pretty girl.
Flirt.
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 Flirt. Okay, there's 190 if it's there. If not, champs are Lutz and his family. Flirt!
Yeah.
You got it. Hey. 251 plays 244. Let's go. Come on. There we go. All righty. Dollar values are triple. This will decide it. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an instrument used by a doctor. Yeah.
Stethoscope.
Stethoscope. You got it. What are you going to do? Quick. Well done. Instrument used by a doctor. You got 3 seconds.
Okay.
Last question. Fifth question is always
okay.
Very quick.
Tongue question. Depressor.
Good girl.
Good one. Good.
Tongue depressor. Good answer. Instrument used by a doctor?
Scalpel.
Scalpel.
Good answer. All right.
One more.
Thermometer.
Good thermometer's answer. There. You keep the
good
title.
Answer.
Thermometer. Well, see, you came very close. You got $244. We have nice prizes for you, and you're a delight to be here. Thank you. We had a good time. We liked meeting you. Thank you, Dad. Thank you. Well, he made the decision, not me. Bye, baby. Who's going to play? Come on. More time, Karen and Gary, $5,000 right after we watch this.
Got.
Look at.
I was just gonna smell your flower.
Okay. I'm in love with a beautiful girl. Ready?
Yes.
15 seconds, please. One measurement of distance is an inch. Name another.
Yard.
Something people do in a booth.
Make a phone call.
A kind of fish you eat often.
Perch.
A fruit used in sauces.
Cherries.
Something that has horns.
A bull.
Very good. One measurement of distance, inch, another yard. Survey said. 15. How many people do in a booth? Make a telephone call. Survey said. Kind of fish you eat most often from the song you gotta
Michigan.
Eat perch. Michigan. Survey said.
That's from Michigan.
Oh, from Michigan. Okay. From Michigan. Fruit using sauces, cherry. Survey said. 3. Something has horns, a bull. Survey said. Come on. Damn, you did well. You are 76 points away from $5,000 more. Please remind everyone the answers Karen gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. One measurement of distance is an inch. Name another.
Yard.
Try again.
Foot.
Something people do in a booth.
Talk.
A kind of fish you eat often.
Shrimp.
A fruit used in sauces.
Tomatoes.
Something that has horns.
A bull.
Try again.
A ram.
Okay. Turn around.
Tomatoes, huh?
It is a fruit.
Is it?
Yeah. It is.
Line center.
Yeah.
No, tomato is a fruit, right? Everybody calls a vegetable. It's actually a fruit. One measure of, I don't think it's going to help you in this, but measure of distance an inch. Name another. A foot. Survey said 29. Mile number one. Something people do in a booth? Talk. Survey said 8. Phone call number one. You're 39 points away. Kind of fish you eat often. You said shrimp. Survey said 14. Tuna.
Tuna.
Number one, tuna. Fruit used in sauces. The tomato. Survey said. Oh! That was wrong. They did it. We'll be back right after this. Say goodbye then.
Goodbye then.
See you here on the Feud. Bye-bye.
Some departing contestants will receive head-to-toe beauty appliances from Conair, a collection of quality personal care products. Conair offers you professional quality for use at home. Seal Emil, your cooking airtight bags to go from freezer to hot water. No mess, no bother. Daisy Seal Emil simplifies your life. From Blue Luster Home Care Products, Blue Luster Dry, the new upholstery cleaner for velvets and other delicate furniture fibers. Make someone happy with Snack and Cake, the cake with a snack inside. Like walnuts, raisins, or chocolate chip, there's a snack inside every Snack and Cake. This is Johnny Gilbert speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.